Okay, so we'll be discussing today's doubts. The first question that we'll discuss is question number 6. In question 6, you have water at 20 degrees Celsius, which is to be cooled to liquid water at 0 degrees Celsius. And for this to happen, we need the heat that is released in the cooling process to be absorbed by ice, which gets heated, rather ice which just melts to become liquid water at 0 degrees Celsius. So the heat lost in this part has to be equal to the heat gained in this part. Now for each individual part, you can write different equations. For this equations, for this part rather, you have to write the heat lost as NC delta T, where delta T is 20 degrees Celsius. C is given in the question here, 75.6 joules per mole. Number of moles can be found out because you have 500 grams of liquid water. For the other part where ice melts in liquid water, the heat gained Q has to be written as N into L, where L is latent heat of vaporization. Now this is the value of L that you have. It's given as 6 kilojoules per mole, enthalpy of fusion. And the number of moles can be written as X, which is, let's say, number of ice cubes into the moles in each ice cube. The mole in each ice cube is just half a mole because it's 9 gram. So you can write that X into 0.5. This is what you can use to solve the question. Okay. Now moving on to the next question. It is question number 8. It says a sample of 2 kg of helium is taken through a process which is given in a PV graph to us. Now we have two different paths. We have path ABC and ADC for two different gases, 2 kg. We have 2 kg of helium in both cases. Okay. Temperatures of state A and B. Because the temperatures of state A and B in this case have nothing to do with the processes. In fact, since the states at A and B have defined values of pressure and volume, you can just write temperature as PV by N. The pressure volume are given, you have 2 kg of helium, so number of moles is known as well. The next question that was asked is question number 10. Says 1 mole of an ideal monatomic gas expands irreversibly in a 2-stage expansion. Now it says irreversibly in a 2-stage expansion, so we'll have to assume that's that it's a it's a single stage expansion in both cases with a constant value of external pressure. So if you have 8 bar 4 liters 300 Kelvin first, which then is expanded to 2 bar and 16 liters, then this takes place at a P external value of 2 bar, for which you can write says total heat absorbed in the process. Okay. For which you can write work done is equal to P external into delta V, comes with a negative sign. This is work done on the system. Similarly, for the second part, the external pressure will become 1 bar. Delta V is given in the question. It can be found from the question in both cases. If you add these two up, we get the total work done. Also, as you can see, the process is an isothermal process. It starts at 300 Kelvin, ends at the 300 Kelvin. So you found out work. Delta U for the ideal gas is NCV delta T, which is 0. So basically, Q plus W can be written as 0. So you know Q for the process. Next is question 11. Okay, the question 11 will come in the next video.